Well, despite the Eurozone's troubles, Turkey still wants to join the club and is renewing its call for European Union membership. Now that Ireland has taken control of the rotating EU presidency, though talks had been suspended due to the lingering dispute between Turkey and southern Cyprus, but as Natalie Carney reports, 2013 may bring some new momentum to the negotiations.
Talks over Turkey's EU membership have lost their dynamism. Only one of the 35 areas of negotiation, or chapters, has been satisfied, while 13 open remain suspended, and a further 17 politically blocked by France under former President Nicolas Sarkozy and Greek Cyprus, not formally recognized by Turkey. But a new year brings with it new optimism.
Well, the Irish are very ambitious, opening up a few more chapters, and François Hollande has clearly stated that they're gonna lift the French blockage over the chapters, and apparently the ongoing financial economic crisis within the European Union at large, Turkey's European bid is going to be a bit more actually lively.
Turkey's economic success has increased self-confidence, leaving many reconsidering the benefits of being a part of the 27-nation bloc. Public support for EU membership has slipped from 77% in the early 2000s to just over 40% last year.
Well, it is questionable to a certain extent. However, politically speaking, in terms of human rights, in terms of democracy, in terms of free speech, in Turkey has a lot to learn from the European Union still.
While Turkey could share its successful economic remedy, the Union is concerned about other ailments. Yet Minister of EU Affairs Egemen Bağış argues that the bloc is being hypocritical.
Most of the criticism that Turkey gets today vis-a-vis human rights, detention periods, freedom of journalism and so forth, are issues that need to be dealt with within the contents of chapters 23 and 24. However, when it comes to Turkey, a country that has already opened 13 chapters, we cannot open those two chapters because the Greek Cypriots are blocking them.
Last year, the EU received the Nobel Peace Prize for sustainable peace across the continent. Turkey claims its membership will help distribute that peace even further.
The political stalemate over Cyprus may be delaying Turkey's progress, but the country's economic success could certainly bode well for some struggling EU nations. Now with Ireland at the helm, Turkey is hoping that the divide between the two may not be as difficult to navigate. Natalie Carney for CCTV in Istanbul, Turkey.